Scarlett is a little bit rumpled, but then again, so am I. As very, very tippity center. Is that a word? It is now. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And I love to play with makeup. I love bold and colorful makeup, as I have on the face today. But I also love neutral makeup. And if you love makeup as much as I do, love a little bit of quirkiness, a little bit of sarcasm thrown in between, and just some random silliness, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button, because I upload regularly. I love the word regularly. I also love the word ghastly. And Wellingtons. Yes, let's just go on with what you clicked on this video for. Today I am reviewing for you the Lucky Bunny Wrath palette. Lucky Bunny Cosmetics is an Australian based indie brand. This is her fourth palette. I did pay for this one myself, and if you want to save some money, I do have an affiliate code. It is listed down in the description box. The palette for me retails for around 21 euros. It depends a little bit on the exchange rate, but it is 35 Australian dollars. You get 12 shades, a combination of mattes and shimmers. The palette is cruelty free but not vegan, or at least it doesn't say so on the back, so I am guessing it's not vegan. You do see that the shade Scarlet is a little bit busted up. That's just, it happened in transit. It happens sometimes. I can still use it though. The owner did contact me and asked if I wanted a replacement palette. I declined because it's only one shade. That's a little bit busted. I can still use it, and I don't feel like it is necessary for her to send a completely new palette my way. I would rather that she sell it, you know?
The palette swatched okay. The reds are pretty dry. These two, so this is the shade Flame and this is the shade Shadow, they feel pretty dry. And here's the shade Scarlet that is a little bit shattered. But yeah, it does swatch very, very well. The shimmers feel as they always feel. It's just that a few of the mattes feel a bit dry. And I don't know if you can see it. I can see it in the pan, but there is a color difference between the red. So for instance, this red, Dakota, is more of an orange red. Then the shade Ayana, which is here, is a little bit more of a pinker red. This is a little bit more of it's a shade darker than the shade Dakota, this one, but still in the same ballpark. So a little bit more of an orangey red. Then the shade Shadow is a dark red, and then the shade Scarlet is basically a true red. I don't think it will translate in the swatches that well, but again, I can see it when I see the palette in front of me.
That is it. I think that is a little bit about the palette and the company up front. This video contains also three looks. I haven't done an eye swatch video with this palette just because I don't have the time for it. That is it. However, I have tested out all the shades on my eyeballs very, very well, and I have formulated my thoughts that I will tell you about at the end of the video. So you get three looks and you get the review at the end of the video as well. Before we go any further, pause the video, grab a drink and a snack. Yes, did you grab a drink and a snack? Now put your feet up, because here comes look number one. The washing machine is in its, what is it called, centrifuge mode. So if you hear anything, it's probably that. I did this part of my face with foundation because I'm experimenting. My friend Liora does this as well, and I thought, let me try it to see if I like it, because I don't like it when this part just underneath my brow is a different color than my foundation. So yeah, am I going to use this one? Yeah, I think I am. I'm going to use the eyeshadow primer in the shade Blank Canvas. This is from AOA Studios. It's just a pot. It's like the MAC paint pot, but it's actually pretty nice. I've been using this for a few days, and I'm going to use it in this video as well, because I'm curious to see how it will hold up with, how it will work with these shadows. So let me just prime my eye. I think I'm going to make it easy on myself and go row by row. I'm going to do this row first, then this row, and then this row last. I'm going to grab a slightly denser brush and go to the shade called Amber, which is the yellow. Yes. I'm going to tap it on my eye. I'm basically going for, I don't know, is it a sunset-y eye?
probably. Now, the base that I have is almost my skin color. And it does show up nicely, so that is good. This brush. I'm going to go to the next shade, which is the shade Ginger, which is the orange. The shades are a little bit harder pressed in the pan, though. I'm going to place it slightly lower. I still want to see the yellow. I'm going to place it in the, what is it, in the high crease. And then I'm probably going to blend it up just a tiny bit. Oh yes, and the beeping, if you hear it, it's my washing machine screaming at me that it is ready. And I'm just going to blend on the edge slightly, just to make sure that the blend is nice. And I don't have a harsh line. Okay, I'm going to go next to the, well, basically the red shade that I'm going to use today, which is called Dakota, which is an orange-based red. This is a little bit looser, it has a little bit more kick up in the pan. And I want this in the depth of the crease. That's what she said. Okay, back to the orange called Ginger. And then I'm going to go back to the yellow. I do want a little bit more depth, I feel, almost. So, I'm going to grab a small brush and I'm going to cheat, as per usual, because I'm going to use the shade Shadow to create a little bit more depth. First I'm going to build up the shade Dakota a little bit more. Yes, now I'm going to go to the shade Shadow, which is the darkest shade in the palette, which is pretty dry shade, though. I don't know how much it will layer. It's a very, very dry shade. Okay, let me grab a clean brush and just go over the crease slightly. Just to make sure that it is all nice and blended. Okay, it's time for the shimmer. And I'm going to clean up my lid a little bit with the NYX Glitter Primer. So I have a little worm of glitter primer on the brush. And it's going to go on my eye. And I kind of want to be a little bit precise. So I'm tapping it on first. Then I'm really stretching my eye and just following my eyeball in the socket. And then clean up a little. Or at least that I don't have any splotchiness. I don't really know what I wanted to say. The shade I'm going to use is the shade called Blondie. Or is it Blonde? No, Blondie. Which is the lightest shade in the palette. A very, very pale yellow. Ooh, that's pretty. I'm just going to press it on. I'm going to go to the shade Amber, which is the yellow matte. I'm going to work that on top a little bit. Because I want to get a gradient here. Okay, and then I'm going to go to Ginger, which is the orange. It's going to go next to it. I'm just using the same brush because it doesn't really matter. And then I'm going to go to Dakota. And then I'm going to go to Shadow. I like this. Then I want a kind of a cleanish brush. I'm going to kind of mix everything together a little bit. Yes, and then just with the same brush, I'm going to go into that shimmer just lightly and lightly dust it over a tiny bit. Yes, then I'm going to go back to the yellow because I'm losing it a little, which isn't weird. I'm basically going to go back to all the shades that I used. So the yellow first, then the orange, then the red. I'm just dusting it over each other just to make sure that everything is the way that I want it. I feel. I'm going to go first to the shade Shadow. High up on the lower lash line, outer corner. Yeah, I thought so. I'm creating fallout now, especially with this shade. So now it's easier for me to clean it up in just a second. Okay. Then I'm cleaning it. I'm going to go to the shade Dakota and it's going to go a little bit lower. And I am connecting it a bit. Then I want to go to the yellow. I know I'm skipping the orange, but if I'm going to blend it out, it's going to kind of turn orange anyway. I'll probably have to redo it when I do my face, but then at least you kind of can see what I did, you know? Okay, I want a yellow eye pencil.
Okay, and then the shade Blondie is going to go there. No, first I'm going to go to the shade Amber, the yellow. Then I'm going to go to Blondie, which is the shimmer.
This is it so far. I am going to finish everything off and then I will be back with the completed look. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Everything is on, here is the completed look.
Falsies are pretty soft for me, at least for the last few days. Last few days I've been wearing pretty dramatic ones. These are also from AOA Studio 3D Foam Ink in the style Nora.
Lippy is from Juvia's Place in the shade Invoke, which is, well, as you can see, an orangey one. This was it for look number one. Let me know down below what you think of it and let's get ready for look number two.
Look number two. I know that I started differently yesterday, or at least in the last look, but I basically forgot that I was experimenting, so I'm starting with a full face. It's just the way it is. Let's hope the fallout is minimum today. I think I'm going to attempt something of a spotlight eye thing. Yes. I'm going to start with the shade called Ayana. I'm just going to tap it on my eye first. First, I'm creating a little bit of a rounded shape. But because of the way that my eyes are shaped, I like it if it is a little bit higher there. I'm just slightly blending it up. Works very, very nicely, this shade. I'm just really making sure that the shade, when it is up higher, it's really soft and blended. I'm going to go to a slightly smaller brush, still the same shade, and I'm going to deepen it up a little.
So basically something like that, yes.
Okay, and then I'm going to go to the shade Flame, which is the darkest of the red here on this row, inner and outer corner and the crease, top and bottom. And then I'm going to make sure that the line isn't as harsh. So just blending the line slightly. Back to the first brush. I think I'm going to grab the shade Shadow, but on a small brush. And the shade Shadow is the darkest matte of the palette. Just because it is, I don't know, lacking a little bit of the depth that I'm looking for. I'm just going to place this in the inner and outer corner again. I almost wish there was a black in this palette. I think this is it for the mattes. So let's go to the shimmers. Then I'm grabbing my NYX Glitter Primer and a smaller brush. Just starting in the center. And I'm concentrating it on the center, in the center, on the center. Wow. I don't need to be that precise, but I'm basically stopping where my eyeball really goes into my socket, if that makes sense. And then here on the outer part, I'm going to tap a little. Okay, first I'm going to go into the shade Vixen, which is the orange. Then I'm going to go into this shade. And maybe I will grab this one for the inner very, very tippity center. Is that a word? It is now. So I'm starting in inner and outer parts with this shade. And I'm slightly tapping it over the mattes as well. Because I want it a little bit less red. That's maybe weird, but then again, so am I. Okay, then the shade Lesha, the goldeny. Cutesy, okay. A little bit of the orange again. And then the shade Lesha, the goldeny. And then with a very tiny brush, I'm grabbing the shade Blondie, which is that yellowy. Just in the middle.
I like that. I want to see if I can kind of replicate it on the lower lash line as well. What kind of eye pencil do I want? Maybe orange and yellow. So I'm also bringing that eye pencil on top of my lashes. Then I'm grabbing the shade Vixen. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to press that on top. Then the yellow eye pencil is going to go in the center. I could have done a very pale gold, actually. And then I'm going to do the same with the shade Lesha. A little bit of smudging. And then the shade Blondie. That's cute. Eek. Clean brush. Let's grab the shade Lesha. And then Blondie. So I'm going back and forth in the goldeny and the yellow. Clean the brush a bit and buff it in. And then a little bit of Vixen, which is the orange. Just to make sure that that is okay. Is there enough depth? Almost. I'm almost done. I'm going to go back to the shade Shadow. It is so hard pressed in the pan, this one. I kind of wish that this one... Well, I wish that this one was looser and had more binders in it, so it was a little bit more creamy. Because then I think it would have been a bit easier to work with. It's just very, very dry. But I just wanted to give a bit of extra depth. I think that's it for this. I am going to do the same on this one. Finish everything off and then I will show you the final look. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. Everything is on. Here is the final look. I like it. Those kind of spotlight halo eye thingamajingies are growing on me. I really do like it. The lippy I have on is one from ColourPop. It is, what is it again? A matte lippy pencil stick thingamajingy. Oh, lippy sticks. It says so on the thing, yes. In the shade Cookie. It's a matte one and I really like the color. And I like it combined with this eye look as well. The falsies I have on are from AOA Studio in the style Jackie, which are... Instead of my flared ones, these are a little bit more, create a little bit more of a rounded shape. And that is what I'm going for when I'm doing a look like this. Instead of the flare, I want that. And then, yeah, that is it. The rest will be listed down in the description box. Look number two, let me know what you think of it down below. And let's get ready for look number three. I am going to start with the shade Shadow. Because I want to see how it behaves when it's not layered. That's the reason. So let me get a brush. I do have to swirl my brush in really, really well though. And I think it's just because the shade is so hard pressed. I'm just tapping it on and then following the line in. Let's blend it out a little. It does blend very, very well, but I just don't think that I can get the depth that I'm looking for. So I'm grabbing my smallest brush. I'm really, really swirling the brush in and I am tapping it off a little. Let's see how deep we can get it. That's a bit better. Okay, and then back to the first brush. Let's also grab a tiny bit of the shade Scarlet, which is the red. And blend out this shade a little. Ooh, that's a nice. Back to the shade Shadow. I actually think I'm going to grab a little bit of the yellow. Just a hint. To blend the edge. I'm going to grab my glitter primer and the flat brush, and the glitter primer is going to go on my eye. Okay, and then I'm going to go to the shade called Portia. Okay, the next shade I'm going to go to is the shade called Sasha, the green. And then one shade, the green, the other shade, the other. I'm just going to flip my brush back and forth to get the two shadows to mix. A little bit of the shade Portia to fade over. And I'm also going to create kind of a wing shape with the green. Okay, let's get a green eye pencil. Is this the green I want? No, this is not the green I want. This is the green I want. and use a little bit of the shade Sasha to blend that out. And then with this brush, I'm just going to make sure that that wing shape is nice and pigmented. I'm going to grab the shade Shadow again. At least I'm trying to. Because I'm going to see if I can make this line a little bit darker, just above the shimmers. Okay, fun! I'm going to do the same on that eye, finish everything off, and then I will be back to show you the final look and give you my thoughts on the palette. Everything is on, here is the final look. I went a little bit overboard with the liner. The wing just kept on growing, so... The lip I paired it with is one from Catrice. It Generation Matte and Exotic Rebel, which kind of helps to bring out the red in the eyeshadow. And the falsies I have on are the ones from Primark in the style Kylie. Yes, it will be listed down below as well, in case you are wondering. I did add an inner corner highlight from the palette. That's the shade Blondie. So yeah, let me give you my thoughts on the palette. Let's start with the performance of the mattes, and then let's start with the shade that I had trouble with, which is this one, the shade called Shadow. I don't like the shade, unfortunately. I have tried it with different brushes. I tried it with natural hair brushes, which usually pick up the most shadow. I tried it with synthetic brushes. I tried it on the primer, that eye primer that I was using, and I tried it on an eye primer that stays sticky. I tried to layer it, I tried to pack it on, and it does blend out beautifully, I have to say that. So unfortunately for me, the shade Shadow just doesn't perform the way that I am used to her shades performing. And I think it is because the fact that it is a very dry formula and it is very hard pressed in the pan. I think that is just it. Overall, the mattes perform very, very well. The yellow is actually a very nice yellow. It's not the absolute best that I have in my collection, but it is a very nice yellow. I love the shade. I love that how it performed. I could pack it on and blend it out without any issues. The rest of the mattes all work beautifully as well. These two created nice depth. This one though, I wish was a shimmer. I do like this one because I can, because the shade Ayana is a little bit more of a pinker red, and I can use the shade Scarlet to very nicely deepen up this shade. I can also use the shade Scarlet to deepen up this one. The shade called Flame is not deep enough for my liking. Because it kind of... If I blend this one out, I get this. Does that make any sense? I wish that this was a shimmer. That is really what I'm missing here in this palette. I miss a red shimmer and I miss a black. That's what I miss. I do like the fact that she put in a green and then this shade. I think that it makes the color story a little bit more versatile and a little bit more interesting. Especially if I were to have a black in the palette that I could use as a base and then create, I don't know, use it, that coolness with these two, you know? Or this one, a very, very deep... It does not even have to be a black. It could be a very, very deep red. Almost black, but still a red. You know, the depth of the shade Lola, but then instead of the purple, that in a red. That is what I'm missing. I'm missing the depth and I'm missing a red shimmer. For the rest, it performed beautifully. The shimmers perform very well as well. This one is a funny one, because when I look at it, I see yellow. But when I put it on my eye, it is almost icy. You can nicely play with that because you can layer it on top of the yellow and you can use it, as I did today, in the inner corner, and then use the iciness to help with the coolness of the rest of the shades. Does that make any sense? Overall, I am very happy that I bought the palette. It's just, yeah, sometimes it happens, you know? Sometimes it just doesn't work out the way you want it to, and I had that with this palette. The shade that I wanted to use to deepen up just didn't perform for me. And that's basically the bad shade in the palette. Yes, I wish that there was a shimmer red in there as well. But that is preference. And I think that is it for my video of today. Let me know down below if you have the palette. Let me know if you have a favorite look. Do I have a favorite look? I don't know, actually. I don't know. all the looks have kind of something. You know, this is not a color story that I would have paired together, but that is sometimes, that is one of the reasons that I go row by row sometimes, to kind of give you options and myself, I don't know, something different to play with instead of the thing that I kind of want to do. That's maybe more monochromatic looks, you know. That's the reason that I went row by row again. And I think that it turned out very, very nicely. And this way I really got to try the shade Shadow and form my opinion on it. Yeah, let me know down below your thoughts. And I will leave my Lucky Bunny playlist underneath the cards for your viewing pleasure. I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to the members that you see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there's a link to join in the description box. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.